Hey, what up? It's your boy, Mr. Wonka 7. I really didn't expect today to be a recording day. Otherwise, I would have been a little more prepared, but you know what? I'm never that prepared anyway, so it doesn't matter too much. That's what I'm trying to say. Oh, I forgot about this. That's gonna bother you if you see that shit for too long. Salamence. Wait, what? Okay, cool. Bet fam. Again, this game is not as interesting when you have less party members. Like with Minwoo, it was kind of fun. With Joseph, it was kind of fun. Even getting my ass kicked with Leon in the beginning was kind of fun. But three guys, it just doesn't work in these old school Final Fantasies. You need like four or five dudes to make it work. Like Final Fantasy VII, yeah, you could really make it work with just Cloud, Baron, and Tifa. Nice shield action. I don't mind if he gets a shield, because it really won't hurt him. I don't want him to have two swords and dual wield anyway. Oh, I'm really getting there. I hope, at least. Yeah, I'm getting there. I just gotta cross the river. Like how they don't flinch when the attack misses. They just come across as stone cold badasses that way. They're not gonna move for no stupid shit. The enemies, on the other hand, are really stone cold. You could freaking shoot them with a gun and they won't react in any way. Not even a flinch. That's kind of what I was hoping for when I would play Treasures of the Rudras. You would see in action like how in 1996 Square games, they finally get animation to work. Like right when it doesn't matter anymore. I mean, look at these enemies, they're just static. I still think I'm not strong enough to go to the wrong spots in these areas. That's the messed up part. I'm only going to Altair to get to the shops. That's pretty much it. Now I can get everyone suited up exactly how I want them to be. Mithril armor. So that's interesting. She can't wear armor. And really, the silver curious. I mean, if you think about it, Mithril is a type of silver. So I can understand that. It's like a battle practical silver, the any good tomes I can use? Okay, so I really don't need to give anyone anything except maybe blank. Wonder if they sell, they don't sell at any of these shops, I doubt it. See? None of that. Let me scroll all the way down to the Final Fantasy section of this walkthrough. Overworld, Sergeant. No, someone's playing some like trap music. Okay, so Cashuan Keep. Oh, I see it. That's where we're supposed to go now. So really, Maria's been ready and now we're all trying to get on her level. I like that. Wait. Okay, so that's a peninsula right there. Wavy. I'm going to be walking the way because as bad as my time preference can be, I actually do want as many good stats for my characters as possible. Oh, Locke's stronger now. That's good. Like, I'm assuming this is one of those games where you don't have to do too much grinding because they have everything sort of regulated. Damn, we're putting in the schwerk right now. It'd be nice if we had another dude with us. Best believe that, I think we'll be fine with just three people for now. Something tells me the enemies don't really stand a chance around here. Good thing poison is temporary in this game, otherwise it would be unbearable. It would be a freaking disaster. Bobsk. All right. The more I think about it, this is not the kind of game you want to play for the summer. This is a freaking like colder weather type game. It's too hot out here for to be doing this shit. That's what I'm trying to say. Hood rat fashion, boy. Even when hit with zeros, he still does that weird hair animation. Yo, hurry your ugly ass out here, Lock Man. Like, Lock's a little more babyface. It's like Tidus and Shuyun. Like, if you actually, like, shave Tidus and Shuyun's head. Like, they would look like different people. Because Shuyin has this, like, really nasty, like, phrenology, like, yo. If you don't make me this chicken, I'm gonna smack you upside the head. But Tidus be looking type, like, gentle and baby face. That's the same thing with like Locke and Furion. Same look, but the faces. Like, Locke is like a baby face dude, and Furion is this ugly ass motherfucker. And it's not that he's ugly, really. I'm saying ugly, but really, it's just that he's got like a really defined, like, handsome face. But I'm used to these like bitch made ass faces for my JRPG characters. Like right now, the female viewers might be thinking, like, what are you talking about with your ugly ass, David? He's not ugly, you're ugly. Nasty ass motherfucker. Did we have homework today, looking ass motherfucker? Sweet, we got three antidotes out of that. All right, hold on, let me read this up. Wish you could dash in the world map. That's one thing I'm not looking forward to. Having to play another Final Fantasy without a dash button. Locke's agility increase. That's an ugly ass mosquito. Like, I find it hard to believe that by the end of this, I'm gonna have like 9,000 hit points. I doubt it. Although, it's because I'd be playing it weird, probably. Like, if I got hit more. And shit, I'll probably be having like 1,000 hit points by now. I would not play this in the NES version, by the way. Like, if you've seen H.C. Bailey's version of this game, like, this playthrough, he just spams like frog, death, stone, whatever. Be turning these guys into all types of monsters, and he wins that way. I smell water here. Oh wow, this sounds really good. This is as far as I got with my last playthrough, by the way. Talk to the fire. Yeah, you need a special piece of wood to light up this flame. So this is as far as I've gotten as a 9-year-old. I haven't really gotten any farther than this portion of the game. I wonder why. Like, no, seriously. This battle theme is way too tense for these whack-ass foes. Hold on. Man, enemies don't drop anything I want. Okay. No, there was a sound effect. Who's this ugly ass dude? Stop looking, bitch. Oh, great. Now I got a boner, too. Do we get like a choice? Like a butt down must type choice? That'd be funny. Okay, so this, like. You know who he reminds me of? He reminds me of like one of the pretty boys from Berserk. And just like grown and not as pretty looking. Heroes first will go south. Fine. Okay, let's get to go the wrong way first to get some items. Oh, you see, like letting me start to pick up now. What the hell is wrong with you, Gore? Fucking loser. So that's a mithril tip mace, battle axe. Let me look at this loser's stats. I don't mean to like bully on him too much. Wow, so he's pretty much a one size fits all type of guy. I'm gonna remember that. Mithril mace, ancient sword. Battle axe. Take the mace. I'm sorry I called you ugly. You're actually really handsome. I don't know. I just feel like making him feel better about himself, even though he's not real. That's actually pretty good. I want to improve this dude's armor because I know I'm going to be using him much later. This is one of the few games with revolving party members where I actually give a damn about the party members that are revolved. Speaking of which, are these monsters like, are they like the rare monsters? In these bullshit ass doors. Bullshit ass trap ass doors. Come on, Gordon, go. You tried. I want to see something for Gordon, that handsome ass devil. Okay. Come on, get a turn in, Gordon. Good job, buddy. Good job. This guy Gordon ain't getting anything. These enemies are whack, that's why. Okay, let's go upstairs. Come on, Gordon. You're a talented guy, you got this. You that guy right now. Okay, his strength increased, that's fantastic. I like my meat grinders to be meat grinders. East of Bend. Okay, let's go, Daddy. Adamant toys. Is this the same? Damn, you really going after Guy. It's because he speaks Beaver, right? You're a little salty about that shit from. Okay, we got a diamond shield. I really don't know the difference, but here, take this shit. Wow, this place is a little linear. Stop going in on my guy. That's my guy. Yo, my son Gordon, we might as well be using three people right now. You gotta put in some more schwerk. Ooh, good daddy. The staff level and the shield level increase, so that means good things are coming to the hood. Okay. Ogres. They look a little different from the Final Fantasy I counterpart we're used to. Wow. Look at that difference. Well, at least his hit points are increasing. Is this dude for real? How, why is he so weak? Stop, man. Stop being whack. Along the southbound path. Okay, I had a feeling. Burn them. Oh. Golden sh. It's like my Chinese food restaurant, Fusing. Oh, wow. Would you want a shield that was sleeping with rats? I'm not gonna give you that nice ass stuff. I like you, buddy, but no. Okay, two paragraphs to go until we get to the interesting part. Oh, hell no. Oh. Ogre mages. Nasty ass, blue ass motherfuckers. Oh, wow. I was about to lose Gordon. But thankfully, now he's probably gonna get a good hit point boost. It just smashed this idiot. My son Guy, you're so good. Okay. Wait, what was that I just saw? Everyone got a turn in on this dude. Oh, that's it. I'm probably gonna get an ac. I knew it. I knew it. I've played this JRPG before. This is every JRPG for being stupid. Every, like, old school one. And us some tea. Kakashuan keep floor 4. Go on to seconds. Okay. Interesting. What are you ODing on my boy Guy for? He's literally going to end up overpowered because of this stuff, this nonsense. I'm gonna need a nap after this. I'm gonna need me some tea after this too. Second southbound path. That's this, right? Or it could be the first one, another one. Again, Keyblade 999. You have a bad way of explaining things, buddy. Ah, she looks cute like that. Damn. Too bad they made this chick extra anime, because now I'm really into her. Freaking Yoshitaka Amano. Oh. It'll probably be really effective for her. I got no, like. Oh, that might be a problem. Could burn this idiot. Let me see. How much damage am I doing to him? Okay, just one more of that and it'll all be okay. Never mind. Let's get out of here. Oh shit, my l son lock came through. See, with Locke, I can always escape. That with a teleport spell, and that might be what I have to do. If things get really nasty. Preemptive strike, preemptive escape. Oh, that was actually a really bad idea. Well, I'll have to keep going after guide and nothing too bad will befall us. Oh wait, it works now? Outside of battle? It's supposed to be a different kind of poison. Like the traditional kind. Okay, so now we got some. Yeah, I'm not doing that again. No offense to anyone, I'm just not going to bother with that crap. So I go south then. All right. Preemptive strike, preemptive victory. That's how it is with these. All right, guy, it's up to you. Yeah. Someone get the turn first. Oh, wow. Now the auto-targeting is acting all types of fucked up. We should still have this. Anyone here have like a cottage or something of that nature? Well, first things first, let me give. Who should have the life tome? You. So we're not gonna have you burn anything right now. Okay. Like, yo. Oh, he's gotten more attack multipliers. That's good. But then again, his sword level did increase, so that is to be expected. The way I see it, we're gonna run our way back. Go to an inn, heal up, stock up on some wares, and then we'll be good after that. 'Cause I don't think we would have stood a chance against the final boss and been able to get out. It's shameful that I had to do that for the first time in a while for a freaking dungeon. But again, this was like the fourth dungeon in the game. Things are picking up. Things are really picking up. Oh, okay. So we should almost be there. Now I see why I got this was like the last dungeon for my 9-year-old playthrough. Adam and Tortoise really does it. Okay. Get out of my way, idiot. You really need a lot of these. This should be able to take you to the whole dungeon. Shut up and take my money. And no one gonna give us problems now. Except for the Edamame choice, of course, but I'm gonna be saving a lot. Which, by the way, is not a good idea. Because you've, in one of my aborted videos, really doing those like saves and then resetting to avoid fighting the Adamant toys, that could corrupt your shit. There could be a communication error. But if that's the case, I'm not gonna lose any sleep over it. This is a frustrating game in general. It has you by the balls. One thing I am concerned about, why isn't Maria's like stats like higher? I should get some ethers just for her. I should stop playing this game like it's the NES version. That's another thing I should do. Status, configurations, bestiary. Okay, pretty good. And yes, I will be changing the way it looks at some point. Just so that it looks more interesting. And we got these customizable interfaces, why not use them? All these times they've given us like stronger dudes than us, and now they give us like this bitch-ass Gordon. Come on, Gordon. Catch up, buddy. It's because of the mechanics that he can't catch up as well. Besides, he's near Maria in terms of hit points. This isn't Final Fantasy I, I'm not that concerned about hit points. We don't have to use that key item anymore. Okay. We got it now. Now I'm going to be saving obsessively. Really, it's sad that I'm so obsessed over a temporary character. But this Dawn of Souls version kind of makes you more invested into them. Okay. This one's a little interesting, but you've seen it in action before. All right, escape or we restart. We restart. Hold up. All right. This is A. So as you can see, encounters don't have a fixed ATB. Or if they do, then I guess resetting affects that. Yeah. Thank you. Mean, ATB manipulation really isn't that much of a variable here. Even then, I'm not going to learn ATB for this kind of stuff. That just sounds way too complicated. Sure. Does this dude have a mullet? What is that? Plebeian in the back, patrician in the front? Get out of here with that. Why does this dude guy look like in his character portrait that his he has a difficult question in a spelling bee? Get that out of here. At least everyone's tanking things better. Don't know why, but I'm happy about that. Hey, that's a nice boost for Fire 3. Her MP needs to increase. That's what matters, really. All right. The hell is wrong with her? Alright, back where I need to be in the walkthrough, I think. Almost there. Think I did a couple strokes too much, but. So I gotta come across the stairway. I'm not gonna worry about being too serious in regards to. Oh, hell no. That's Wallen. What's with this crowd control? I don't feel like doing it this way. It doesn't have to be this way anywhere. This guy wants me to crash my shit, right? That's what this is all about, right? Yeah, well, this I can work with. All that other riffraff is just annoying. I'm determined to get all the treasure here. I should actually do a screen, a save state. That might be the smartest thing I can do right now. Oh. Well, you already snow. Clap the Ogre Mage ASAP. Yes, guy. The ogre mages here, for some reason, are actually mages. Guess that's just one mechanic they didn't really include in the original Final Fantasy that they probably meant to. If my poutiness and is getting to you, yeah. This area is getting to me, but I'm almost done with it anyway. Is an old school title. If you don't get that reaction, then you're just made of stern stuff, buddy. Nice. So is that where the treasure is at? I'm not gonna think too much about it. Oh yeah, I already got the golden armor. Well, upgrade yourself, Gordon. I would try to go get the other treasure to upgrade Gordon and get him like a better mithril weapon, but I like what he has right now. Oh, that treasure sounds so appealing. Go west, north to a door. The strategy remains the same. Go after that ogre mage. Make him suffer. Think that ice cream also took a lot out of me. I don't know. I think I go through the quickest sugar crashes in all of time. But that was some good ass ice cream though, so it don't really matter. Mithril helm? As an item completionist, this place is probably getting on my nerves because there's a lot of interesting stuff that I want to get. Specifically, that Werebuster. That sounds cool. Keshuan Keep. This is where the loot's at. Nah, this is some other shit. Good thing you don't go up levels for healing like this. So he starts off ambushing you. But it's nothing really to write home about. All right. Well, this ain't right. So apparently you'll get a big physical stat upgrade in this because you'll be attacking a lot, but you won't be doing much else. And damage isn't really that good. I'm going to need a better FAQ for this. All right. Okay, heal Maria. Shell everyone and okay. Sweet. Okay, finally we're doing damage. Oh, it's because he's cursed. I should have used that sword a long time ago. I didn't know its advantages. I thought it made you curse. Well, now I feel stupid. Speaking of which, all right, I forgot about these. I have them. I have a lot of them. See that? Now we're meat grinders. So with that, like an ancient sword, I could have really done damage a long time ago to a lot of these bosses. Now I feel really stupid. What about this adamant toys? Thank you. All right. Sweet. This changes everything. Curse that is just like dangerous. How is his sword level now? It's level 6. And he recovered from that quickly. Also, the only reason I'm still here is because of the Werebuster. That's pretty much it. I didn't know that Locke at this point had become such a beast just for getting a new sword. Like some would say this is game breaking, but actually it's game making. Now I can go ham on this. Like when he starts off with Blink. What are those Arab dudes screaming outside my window? Funny thing is, they're not even Arab, they just sound like it because they sound really angry. So there's that floor over there. How do I get to it, though? Good, his strength is going up. So he should be capable of defending himself from now on. Not that I'll turn my back on him. Now he got debuffed. This fight would have been the death sentence, but now he's the one with the death sentence. Fantastic, boy. I feel powerful now. Sweet. How do I get to that part of the? Oh, I know what that is. Yeah. I really don't like being fed as I'm given a recording session. Especially this whack ass, depressing ass food. Oh, wow. Oh, this is where I'm supposed to get this stuff from. Mithril Sword, Werebuster. Spike makes effective against werebeasts. Congratulations! Now you're gonna be extra useful now. Oh, speaking of which. Really? Yeah, one of the most important things about JRPGs is the fact that wow, his hit points are that low. I would have never known. Equipment matters more than your base stats and your level. Now I gotta go. Four hours into this game. Wow. I really want ham. Me take a bite out of this chicken breast. It's not good. Not good whatsoever. All right. Yeah, this is why I do my recording sessions not on Sundays and Wednesdays. I gotta get my phone.
What? It wasn't that good.
Well, obviously, I'm not done with this recording session just yet. Want to clear the whole chapter out first. Oh, I forgot. Naturally, if we have Eggle's torch. We light it up. So now even Gordon is putting in that work. Mean, it took time. It really did. But besides the gloves, Gordon is that guy right now. Oh, that's a big ass ship. What kind of work are they putting on that? I never saw this scene. This looks wild. That was weird. So yeah, Sid just got busted. If you've ever been to the hood, you've probably seen a car chase. Well, that's kind of how it looks like, but with air instead of road. The last time I saw like police officers chase like a car was 2 years ago on my way home from school. That was pretty cool. Here's something else I've never gotten before, which is actually very important to mythology of this story. That little circle right there will take you to a chocobo. This is the first game to have that. It also has like the worst chocobo theme. It's extremely repetitive. Of course, I hope for this version they actually. Nope. It's this annoying ass little loop. This technological waste of flesh, musical flesh. Opening. All right, let's try this out. You can't hear music from your end because I'm using headphones to record these, but trust me, the theme is extremely repetitive. It's not nearly as good as in the later installments. Mean, yeah, I still pick up the folksy elements, and I think that sounds great. But give it a rest. It just sounds horrid. Least this is a really efficient form of transportation. Like, no one can say anything about this. Really, from all of that? Pallium, Poft, Cespallium. This is my current position. Yeah, I did this a little wrong, but it doesn't really matter. Anyway. Oh, I really took the wrong direction. I have to talk to someone. Yep, Gordon is ready. Like Trey Songz. Should I even bother with that? Full mace. No point. It's not gonna boost it by much. Because he'd be using his whack hand. These guys suck. So Gaitreya is right there. Yeah, we've been here plenty of times, but it never really amounted to much as a place. I should start speaking less softly. This is Finn, right? All right, that's Finn. We're gonna be here much later on, maybe like 2 episodes ahead. Okay, let's see. Northwest. Fine. Hopefully we'll be strong enough to deal with the foes here. Same weaklings. Besides, I don't think we'll be able to. Maybe Locke and Guy, but Maria and Gordon, hit points wise, they still got a ways to go. So glad I made Maria into a spear user. Riddus Dread. This has to be the right area if we're fighting ogres. And we have to be ready for dealing with them like this. Yes, yes. I remember fighting these as a kid. If I ever ventured to the wrong spot, they would kill the crap out of me. Oh. So where's this dreadnought? You. Sure, I'm going the right way. Oh, Thunder Tome and a Scourge Tome. That might be useful. I'll distribute them later. At least they still have some punch on them. Damn, Gordon. Alright, guy. Show us why you that guy. Damn, how long until we get to this corner? Damn. Say what now? The hell did I do? Okay, I got the world map ready. Oh, okay. So I know what happened now. Upon arriving in Dreadnought, go north and you'll find a guard. Give him this thing that you found. And you know who probably gave it to you? The Dark Knight. It was in a chest in that place we were underground, like a Bosque, the Bosque sewers. This guy's pissing his pants. Talk to them and you'll fight them. Damn, Gordon. It was good with you, boy. Huh. So I wonder how strong these sergeants are. Pretty powerful. As soldiers, they're just there for moral support, really. He's not going to be a contributing factor into this match or this contest. His might just isn't right. Sleep Blade. Okay. So let's see Locke's new found powers. Nice. A meat grinder has been discovered. The top, go west, find a chest with 600 go. Alright. These guys need to take care of a dreadnought. This is a very polluted place. Or, best word is infested with pests. All right, past the staircase. My whole team putting the work in here. Let's see. Go east. Damn, we're just putting in work. I've been saying that so much, but really. This has me itching to play Romancing Saga again. And our tech functions as crowd control. Heck yeah. Mines, let's see if they're going to be trouble now. They have that potential, but freaking Gordon with that Werebuster. Go south to Fork. Okay. I really shouldn't leave this food out. Yeah. I potion. I gotta sneeze. Well, he is holding the Werebuster and well, if you're paying attention, these are werewolf-type enemies. So that's why he's doing extra damage. Making my hood look good. And a preemptive strike? We're catching that victory in. Dark bow. I don't really like using bows anyway. All right. Thieves gloves. All right. I'm gonna give it to her because she has the lowest hit points of our permanent cast right now. So boost up her defense and make her a little more agile. And plus she's hot, so I'm gonna give her favoritism on that merit alone. Gone. Pathetic. Least he got cursed, so his defense will drop along with his attack. And you thought we weren't gonna be worth a damn as potential rebel warriors. All right. Damn, Gordon. You're gonna be a fiend in the post game. That is until you get replaced by people who are obviously better than you. Damn. Flawless victory after flawless victory. This recompenses that dull part of the previous area. All of this Final Fantasy 2 got me craving Wild Arms right now, but that's for tomorrow, Daddy. And her agility goes up even more. Man, I eat Chinese food for breakfast, even though it's not healthy. Yeah, ain't shit to me. Stunner? A daddy? Just Guy and Gordon are really fiends right now. Equipment means everything in this title. Okay, third floor. What am I supposed to do here? Okay. So I could just skip this. Gone. That was mean. But ultimately, that's all it is, because that mind can't do anything to me. These Dark Knights just look badass. Like right now, we can fight the captains by talking to them, but it would deplete way too many of our resources. It'd be more strategical to just wait until we're supposed to battle them to battle them. Okay, Dreadnought, fourth floor. How many paragraphs of this hellhole do I have to go through left? All right. Honestly, I'm in the mood to listen to rap music, not play video games. I think about it. That's the utter mood I'm in. Either play music, listen to rap, or this. Main Gotch, Giant's Home. So what's this trident thing? Okay, that's a spear. Most other thing I got. Main Gotch. Also got a Giant's Home. Okay, it's a knife that raises evasion. Take that. Oh, wow. I've seen NBA players from the 70s with more subtle physiques than that. All right. Heal your mans, boy. All right, it's up to you, guy. Well, actually, not really, if you're gonna be playing that way. Equipment. I don't really care about shields nowadays. Okay, to the central staircase. Preemptive strike, preemptive victory. Damn, Maria's agility is really going through the roof. Damn. Let's see. Oh, and if you talk to these guys and fight them, they won't disappear, even if you beat them. Okay. Helldiver. Guy still has his mithril things, that's why he's not a powerhouse no more. Again, equipment matters a lot. It's enough for healing for now. How do I bypass any of these guards? They don't seem to be moving. Oh, I've got my lefts and rights, my cardinal directions actually confused. This is actually common sense. Stunner. You know how the story goes. Preemptive strike, preemptive victory. You know, if these guys didn't have vision problems, they could probably. Like, catch me right now. It's not even vision problems, because I'd be right in front of them. It's that unless I approach them, they don't do a damn thing. It's like next level incompetency. Damn, we need to upgrade guys' stuff. Nothing to the left of me, nothing to the right of me. Snowcraft. I should see a throwing animation. I mean, you could have used the throwing animation of the bouquet in Final Fantasy VI for that opera scene, opera house scene. Obviously, that's Leon. Being the thick-headed dumbass that he is. Well, now I can be hands-off as much as I want to. Too bad this place didn't have any boss battles. I would have loved to fight Leon. This is intense. This is just funny. With them running in slow motion, running like it's a fire drill. Although that is how you're supposed to handle this. If you want to get out of like a burning building or a burning airship, you're going to have to do it like size order, line up. All that sheesh. But nice, they're really giving you your money's worth for some of these scenes in FF2. All right. Get out of my face with your weak ass. I think like Scott and Joseph are the most prepared characters, maybe Minwoo for the bonus dungeon. Where's the inn around here? So that's the armor shop, I know that much. for this raggedy ass, ransacked ass inn. I mean, I know you need the money to repair, but sheesh. Although, to be fair, we do have four bodies on us right now. I like in Romantic Saga where, like, your reserve party members just sit there while you sleep, stand, or sleep on the floor, since they don't get no beds. What am I doing? So that king in his deathbed, well, he's dead. Oh, no, he's just in his final moments. You better take those words seriously, boy. Ultima, the biggest waste of time ever. Man, that spell sucks. At least his death animation is acceptable. Man, the good bacteria in this game work very well. Although, it'd be nice if they left the bones behind and maybe fossilized those as well. Alright, it's been a long ass video. It's been your boy, Mr. Wonka 7. Thank you guys for watching, and Uxie, I'm 8 day, everybody.